Ah, hello everybody. You just caught me washing my hands. It is the first day of October, or the first part of October. So we have to save. We've got 2 days to plant either wheat or barley. I think we're going to do barley. Or we can plant a fertilizing crop, oilseed radish, and wait to plant something more lucrative. Sorghum would be nice, but I think we'll do barley, I think. It's a good plan. So, as you can see, I kind of finished the driveway area. Started to put up a fence, and we ran out of money to extend the fence all the way to where I wanted to do it. So, that's where we stand. I finished dumping the gravel last night, spreading it out. Just in case it rained, I put the seed packets here in the garage, or the big bales here in the garage. Also park the truck in the garage. We've actually got a ton of room over on this side too, so we might be able to get both tractors in. We'll just have to, the one we don't plan to use in the winter time will park over this area, I think, which will probably be the Fiat, since it's an open cab. And we'll leave the Ford accessible if we need to do anything in the winter. I mean, we should probably get a bucket for it so we can clear snow. Let's let the Fiat warm up. Our cedar with some seed. Today we are planting the field. Is full. It only holds 700 liters, but we'll see what we can get done. Start at the far end over here. some crop in the ground so that we can hopefully make some money from harvest time. Make straight rows best we can. These first two will be a little wonky because of the way the field is. Couldn't make an easy field shape, could I? Had to go with unique. Well, I wanted to maximize the space we had, so. Shouldn't take too long. Went pretty well. Today we'll probably be done planting this field by 9 in the morning. Hopefully. It's a little interesting. Oh, looks like we're planting wheat because we didn't change. I didn't change the seed type. Too happy that we were actually planting the field, but I didn't think to change it. Oh well, wheat works. Alright. I think we'll go into a bit of a montage fast forward. And that to get the rest of the field planted, you get the basic concept. We lower the cedar, we drive up the field, we raise the cedar, turn around, lower it again, drive back up the field. Back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. So I will see you guys once we finish planting. guess it was a bit optimistic to be done before 9, but we're done before 10. Field is planted. Stick this in front of the subsoiler here. Field is nice and planted. I guess the next step would be to fertilize it, but we don't have any of the equipment to do that. Alright, we've got this sprayer that's on sale. 23. There's herbicide and fertilizer. Good to know. The mower, that's a lot for a big mower. Oh wow. That's expensive. What's that I'm working with of? 36 meters, holy crap. This would do the field in like one pass. We don't have that kind of money to drop yet. That's kind of what we need, especially if we start getting into bigger fields. Regular price on that one, 65, and it's on sale for 23, okay. The tow behind. I guess that's kind of what we gotta look to work towards. Hopefully it stays there, nobody else grabs it. But we're gonna have to cut some trees down to be able to afford it. What's the working width on it? Oops, wrong one. 33 meters, so that's another one, like one pass of the field and we're done. Luckily, we've got plenty of trees we can take down. I do promise at some point we will not be taking any more trees down unless we absolutely want to. Not because we need to. Or we'll switch this to like a winter time activity where we can do this in the winter months when we can't really do anything else. end, hopefully we'll get to the point where maybe we can buy the harvesting machine instead of having to do it by hand. Set up a nice little logging side business that we work on in the wintertime. Oh, we destroyed it. Be careful. If that's something we could do, spend the winter months harvesting trees, building up a stockpile of them, and then in the spring and summer, once in between working on fields, we could, if we have the money, set up a, like, sawmill, make planks, and then take the planks to make furniture, and then sell the end product. Have that run like during the summer, but we have a huge stockpile of wood that we collected over the winter. And then of course, replanting trees and stuff in the, so that they're ready. Come on. Hopefully they'll be grown. They'll do it in sections. And we harvest a section, we plant a section, and we harvest another section, we plant a section. That way by the time we're done with the whole area, the first section should be fully grown and ready to harvest. Sustainable logging. Downside is, it's extremely lucrative, but the logging equipment is expensive. Please don't roll into the lake. Okay. That. Well, 28,000 from 2,000. Not bad. Get rid of the stumps. Okay, so that's enough to get to use sprayer, but and we also need to get fertilizer and forklift forks for the front loader. So we might want to take a couple more down. Just so we don't continually keep emptying the bank account. This guy. Get rid of. That guy. That one. Of course it fell directly where I didn't want it to go. Be enough. And we deleted that tree. Awesome. Oops, I missed that. Missed a bunch. And we delete that. Okay, let's get these sold and see where we stand. Got the one up here on the hill somewhere. Oh no, we deleted that. That one got deleted. Never mind. That might be enough. I don't want to lose this one. Somebody else buying it. Wow, that's expensive. 2,000 liters. All right. Wanted it, but But I thought, let's get rid of the weight on the back. I don't need it. Take this guy up to the shop and we will grab our new equipment. So I will see you when we get up to the shop. Is like bigger than our tractor. That's one thing we probably should have looked at before we bought it. Doesn't have a horsepower requirement. Okay, never mind. Not a problem. So either of these tractors should be able to run it. Wow, that is bigger than we are. This will add some weight to kind of balance. This tractor doesn't have airline connections. Alright, so we won't be able to use this tractor for it. It's fine. This is our utility tractor. Fiat should be able to handle it, I think. Nice leisurely stroll back to the homestead. That's why I get license plates pretty much on all the equipment that I can, so we can drive up and down the roads legally with it. Not have to worry about trailering everything everywhere. Not that here matters, being that it's a single dirt road and there's no traffic. But it's just a habit. That I've gotten into from playing other maps. I honestly can say that since 22 came out and all the times that I've played it, I have yet, this will be the first time to use a liquid fertilizer spreader. I've always used a solid. I've lost my up and down for some reason. Now I got it back. That's weird. Oh, it doesn't work that way, does it? Fiat. This one hopefully should have all the connections. fun. It is a little daunting trying to control something this big. Especially in this area. I don't think we're close enough. Once we get most of the field. Oh, that stupid boat. Come on. Wait for the crop to start to grow and we'll fertilize it again. But second time. Field should be fertilized 50%, I believe. We missed a little section there, but oh well. Like I said, as long as the majority of the field gets fertilized, I am happy. Leave him in there. The Ford can sit outside temporarily because it's got an enclosed cab. I'd say we clean up the yard a little bit, but we don't really need to. Everything is pretty much put away. Track that closer to the house. Ford up close. Front of the Fiat. Put that down because we did a lot of logging today. We did some field work. Got everything I wanted to get done today done. Now I think it's just time for us to sit and relax and enjoy the rest of our afternoon and try to figure out what we will be doing tomorrow. I contemplate opening up another field, but the Fiat's, at least this Fiat, struggled in unopened ground trying to pull the cultivator to open the ground. So I think that would become too much of a, like, nuisance or too troublesome for us to do. We could always take out that tree and that tree, and then maybe those two. We could put a field here, like from that rock, put a nice sized field in here. We also have to look at road paths in, okay. Well, that feel. Maybe that's what we'll do tomorrow. We'll work on clearing some of those trees that we have left out. And working on building road access over here. We've got all this that we can play with and all of this. We've got that group of trees to take out. See, if we do get into logging, 22, 12, these are the sections that have nice trees in that we'll have to purchase. We'll also have to purchase 24, 23 so that we can get road access in. So we need to figure out, I guess road across the top of the properties would work perfect because that'd be a straight line. And then down into this area. I don't know. Maybe that'll be a tomorrow project and figure out road access. Because that's going to be next. So that we have road access. Easy road access to all our fields. Other than the one here at the house. Get rid of some of these. That bush needs to go. These bushes here need to go. We can do that tomorrow. If I want to finish the fence along here, ending about right here, I think, for the fence to kind of separate the driveway from road access or field. But that stuff we'll look at tomorrow. Of course, we'll have to deal with a few more trees to make some money tomorrow, but I don't think that's anything that's going to hamper us too much. So I am going to sit here on the little bench and enjoy nature, watch the clouds go by for the rest of the afternoon, just sit back and relax, And I guess I will see you guys tomorrow.